Hi students, I am Pavan, your science master. In this video, I am going to talk to 6th standard students. Students, what we have been talking? We have been talking about what do animals eat chapter. That's 4th chapter. And we have completed how the animals track their food and how the animals take their food. And what are the body parts involved in taking food and what are the senses used by them in tracking their food and all. We have also talked about the shapes of beaks of different birds and estimating their food habit based on the shape of their beaks. Okay students, and I already gave you some project works like, you know, what are the shapes of beaks of different birds and what are their food habits. I asked you to collect the pictures of the beaks of different birds and to write their food habits. I hope you have done that. Okay students, in this video what I'm going to talk to you is I want to talk about different animals like frog and dog and cow, cat, tiger and lion. How do they catch their food? Okay, how do they catch their food? Let us talk in this video students. Okay, let us talk. First of all, let us talk about how does a frog get its food, how does a dog get its food, and how does a cow get its food. Okay students, and also some other animals there we will speak about how do that animals also get their food. Okay, first of all, let us talk about how does frog get its food. Okay students, let us start about this first of all. See, you might have seen the frogs jumping, you might have played the frog jump game sometimes in your house or in your schools as well. Students, the frogs not only jump and they are very alert in collecting their food. How do they collect their food? How do they collect in the sense not only finding, for finding the food they use their eyes and they see and find it, the sense of vision, and in taking the food, what body part of the frog is used in getting food, taking in food? Yes, here we can understand its tongue is very active part in collecting its food, okay, in taking its food and in getting its food. Okay, here for example, if you see the frog, when it finds food, frog slowly moves forward and it throws its sticky tongue towards the food. The food may be insect or whatever the food that frog finds. Students, like this, the frog throws its tongue. The tongue is sticky in nature. Once the tongue is thrown towards the insect, which is food for the frog, and the insect gets stuck to the tongue of the frog, and immediately the frog takes the tongue back into mouth and swallows it. Did you ever see the frogs catching its food like this? Yeah, and what are the other living things find their food same like this? Yeah, lizard as well. Lizard also finds its food, or lizard also catches its food like this. You might have seen in your houses lizard walking on walls slowly. If you see a light, switched on light, and the worms around the light, you will definitely see the lizard slowly walking close to the light and catching the insect. How does it catch? It catches by throwing its sticky tongue and swallows it. And one question to you students. Do these animals like frog and lizard have teeth? No, they don't have teeth. And they immediately swallow it. Okay, some questions related to these, let me ask you. Some questions like, you know, find out where does the frog live and how it feeds there. Where does the frog live and how it feeds there. And also next question related to this is observe. What you going to do? Observe how lizard catches its food. Okay, its food. Okay, observe and write your observations. Observe how lizard catches its food and write your observations. Food and write. Okay, this board I want to use for giving assignments and drawing different diagrams here. And let us see about this. Yeah, this board only. Next. And also, next one more question. Find the differences between frog and lizard. The way of taking their food. Find the differences between frog and lizard in taking their food. The way of taking their food or getting their food. And not only frog and lizard, you just mention other living things which use their tongue as a tool in getting their food. Okay, this is about frog and the lizard, and then you have to find the differences between frog and lizard. Okay, students. Next, let us talk about second question. Here, second one is how does the cow get its food? Okay, I will give little bit information about this and I'll give you some questions to write on your board. Okay, students, have you got it? Yeah. Most of the village people, they depend upon the cattle. Cattle in the sense, the animals together like cow, buffalo, goat, sheep, etc. Students, let us talk only about cow here and then we compare the way of finding or getting food of the cow with other animals. Okay,
Did you ever see a farmer or a villagers feeding or grazing the animals in their villages? Yeah, where do they feed? Where do they graze? They graze in the fields. Okay, they get their food in fields. What is the food of cow? Grass. Okay, how does it collect its food? How does it get its food? With the help of mouth. Okay, with the help of what? Mouth. And what are the parts of mouth of a cow? Tongue and strong upper jaw and lower jaw. And one thing that you need to understand, does the cow have teeth on both the jaws or one jaw? If the teeth present on one jaw, on which jaw? Upper jaw or lower jaw? Do you know that? Yes. The cow consists of teeth on lower jaw, not on upper jaw. Okay, students? And its tongue also plays a major role in collecting its food. Okay? The animals like cow, goat, sheep and all, they put the grass in between upper jaw and the lower jaw teeth and cuts it and moves its head up and down like this and cuts the grass and takes in. And as soon as it cuts the grass and takes into mouth, that partly chews it and swallows it and keeps in its separate portion of the stomach. And after some time, when it takes rest, it brings the food which was swallowed earlier and it brings back into mouth and again chews it and swallows. What do you call this process? This process is called as what? Rumination. The animals which follow this rumination are called ruminants. Okay, what is rumination? It's a process of bringing the food back, partly digested food, back into mouth and chewing it again and swallowing. You might have seen some animals leisurely sitting under a tree and moving their mouth. What do we call that? Rumination. What do we call that? Rumination. Yes. And make a list of the animals which ruminate. What are the ruminant animals? Okay, students. And this is about this. And some questions related to this. How does cow gets its food? Not only cow, you know. What is the food of the cow? What is the food? Grass. And most of the grass eating animals are ruminants. Most of the grass eating animals are ruminants. Okay? Right. And here, some questions related to this. How does a cow take its food? The question related to this explanation. And then, how does a cow start eating? Okay. Next question. Which parts of cow mouth are involved in eating food. Okay, next question. Does cow have teeth? Does cow have teeth? If so, that means if they have teeth, on which jaw? Upper jaw or lower jaw? The teeth present on upper jaw or lower jaw? Or else on both? Or else they don't have teeth on both the jaws? That you have to write. Okay, answers for these questions. And also, you need to write about what is rumination. What is rumination? This is about cow. How does it get food? How does it get its food? Okay, this is about cow. In this video, we have talked about what? Frog and cow. In the next video, we will do comparison between dog and cat and other animals. Okay, this is for this video, students, and thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.